So I, and I think others, have been tracking what appears to be a pretty dramatic ideological evolution on the part of Tulsi Gabbard, which to this point had mostly been in the realm of sort of culture, things like immigration, where you could say, okay, she always had a little bit of a different stance, things like national security.
Abortion too, actually.
Yeah. Now we're seeing some comments on economics that are just polar opposite of where she was just a couple years ago when she was launching her presidential campaign. Let's take a listen to those comments and then we'll react on the other side.
Here's the reality with the bill that they're continuing to push forward is that our government is too powerful and too big even as it is, and this bill is only going to make matters worse. The provisions in the bill are so vague that really it's going to be unelected bureaucrats who end up deciding how these provisions are implemented, and no accountability. And really it'll empower them to be able to stick their noses into every aspect of our lives, furthering this cradle-to-grave mentality of government dependence that makes us lose even more of our autonomy as we are paying for it. As government gets bigger, our wallets are getting smaller.
Cradle-to-grave mentality of government dependence. I mean, first of all, you could take this from any conservative talking point ever. It also sounds exactly like the stuff Joe Manchin has been saying. And just to remind people, like, when she was running for president, not only is she voiced support for Green New Deal, she was actually to the left of AOC on the Green New Deal because her qualm about it, her one concern was that it opened the door for nuclear. Mm-hmm. She's for Medicare for all, $15 minimum wage, free community college, universal pre-K, prescription drug price reform, all of these things. So listen, I get it. I have my own critiques of Build Back Better, but it's remarkable to see how dramatically her entire ideology seems to have changed. And, you know, again, if you want to critique Build Back Better and the Biden administration, we do it here all the time. One potential line of inquiry you could that would fit with the Tulsi of old is the fact that it looks like most millionaires, we can throw this tweet up on the screen, it looks like most millionaires are actually going to get a tax cut.
Yes.
In this end result. So that's not great. And so just as one more reminder of what Tulsi used to sound like on these things, this is not ancient history. This is her launch speech for her presidential campaign. Here's the way that she used to talk about economics and about the country writ large. Let's take a listen.
We have to fight to make sure that every single American gets the quality health care that they need through Medicare for All. We must stand up against the big Wall Street banks who gamble with our money and our future. Stand up against overreaching intelligence agencies and big tech companies who take away our civil liberties, privacy, and freedoms in the name of national security and corporate greed. We must stand up against those who pollute our land, our water, and our air. We must stand up against private prisons who are profiting off the backs of those who are caught up in a broken criminal justice system. A system that puts people in prison for smoking marijuana while allowing corporations like Purdue Pharma, who are responsible for the opioid-related deaths of thousands of people, to walk away scot-free with their coffers full. This so-called criminal justice system, which favors the rich and powerful and punishes the poor, cannot stand. We must join hands and stand up against those who perpetuate bigotry, hatred, and violence against our brothers and sisters because of their race, religion, or sexual orientation.
She goes on to say, listen, we got to bring the troops home so we can spend money here. Very, very different from this cradle-to-grave dependency stuff that we're hearing now.
I was shocked whenever she did not more forcefully back Biden on Afghanistan. That was really the time when I was stunned, right? And especially in that, I think it was a Tucker appearance where he brought her on to criticize the military on the drone strike. And I think she didn't even defend it, but she's like, well, you know, sometimes. I was like, what the hell is going on
here? He gave her a layup to criticize him from the left over the drone strike.
That's right.
And instead, she wanted to talk about Islamism.
Yeah, I was really shocked by that. And look, maybe she's evolved. It's very possible, you know, Build Back Better or whatever in terms of what's happening here. But it is, look, I'll have a soft spot for her from the campaign. She stood up to a lot of stuff in the face of a lot of overwhelming pressure. It's just the question of where she wants to go from here on out. You know, but going on, and especially on Sean Hannity and talking about it in this particular way, because it's always going to be like former Democratic congresswoman, mm-hmm. you know, yeah. like that's how this works whenever it comes to Fox and more. And so by going on and pushing that, it is a change, obviously, from where she was in the past. The only question is whether she, you know, genuinely believes it or if she's doing it because she thinks it will help her current brand.
Listen, I've known Tulsi for a long time.
Yeah.
I met her for the first
Friends
time.
Friends of the show for a long time.
When she right. first ran for Congress, you know, we've defended her a million yeah. times from
Many
what
times.
Were utterly disgusting attacks. And people can have genuine evolutions. I mean, I've gone through my own yeah. genuine
same.
Evolution.
Right.
You have as well. You know, my views
Huge.
Are not the same now as they were, for example, all back when I was at MSNBC. But I think when you have a position of such prominence, if you did go through some sort of genuine evolution, you owe people a little bit of an explanation of what's going on
yeah,
there.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Because again, it's not like, oh, I've just like I tweaked my view on this or whatever. No, this is like you used to have a completely different philosophy and ideology almost across the board.
Mm-hmm.
So it's hard to understand exactly what's going on with that when, again, you know, just months and, you know, years ago, it was Medicare for all, it was Green New Deal, it was we got to bring the troops home and spend the money here instead. And now she sounds exactly like, you know, any of Sean Hannity's other guests who would come on and bemoan the big government right. and the cradle-to-grave dependency mentality, et cetera. So... it's puzzling.
Puzzling indeed.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. We'll have more for you later. Hey, guys. Thanks so much for watching.
That's right. Just as a reminder, you can become a premium subscriber today. Watch the full show completely uncut. Our reactions to each other's monologues. You get to listen to it. You get to ask us questions. All that good stuff. Link is right there in the description or at breakingpoints.com.
Best of all, great way to say screw you to the mainstream media.